Hello, Regina. How are you? Can you hear me? Hello, hello, Regina. Mario, can you hear me?
Hi.
Hi.
Morning.
Morning, thank you.
Yes,
Okay.
can you hear me?
Okay, perfect, thank you. So, in 5 minutes, so thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, good morning. Hello, hello. Hello, nice to read you, Diana, Gabriel, Alexia, Regina, Mario. Hey. Hello, Gabriel. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. I enjoy that you are online. Hello, Alexia. Good morning. Good morning. Okay, so we all have a minute to start our activities. So I suppose that the students are going to join us. Okay, Carlos is now with us. Okay, good morning. Okay, good morning, Sofia. Hello. Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, so let's start. So today we're going to continue checking all the vocabulary, all the structure that we were using during the module one. But before we start, I would like that you help me with this introductory activity. So today, at the end of my school activities, I need that you tell me, what can you do? What can't you do? So please, can you write three sentences, affirmative using can't, and three negative sentences using can't? So remember, today at the end of my school activities, this is the last class, I can. So please, can you do that activity? As hello, Carlos, as we hope that we have the other students. Just let's take 3 minutes that you write your sentences, your ideas. So, but this is so important that you say, today at the end of my school activities, I can or I can't, according to the duties that you have, please. Okay, if you have some ideas, you can share on the chat or you can use your microphone. What can you tell me about the end of my school activities? What can and can't you do? Okay, so you are free to write on the chat or use your microphone and you can tell me. Okay, hello, welcome back to all my students that are joining to the class. Okay, hello, everybody. We are solving this introductory activity. We're thinking that this is the last class of the day. So I need that you tell me today at the end of my school activities, I can or I can't. So, as you have your ideas, please, if you're so kind to share by chat, or you can use your microphone. And let's share your ideas. What kind of sentences can you tell me? So if you are ready, if you have one sentence, two sentences, you can write on the chat. Or you can speak also. Okay, Diana. Okay, vamos a ver si alguien más tiene problemas para escucharme. Diana dice que ella me escucha, que se va trabando la idea. ¿Los demás cómo me escuchan?
Se escucha bien.
Okay, gracias. Carlos dice que se escucha bien. Adán dice que se traba un poco. Recuerden que tengo el mismo problema, pero es mi internet. How to say gritar in English? Shout. 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 También sometimes we use scream, pero ya depende si es grito que nada más, ah, o shout si vas a gritar alguna información. Okay. Recuerden que Webex es muy, muy, muy especial para todo esto. Entonces, si no me escuchan bien, pueden volver a salir, pueden volver a entrar. No se apuren. Luego, más o menos, se va mejorando conforme vamos trabajando. Y es que también somos bastantitos en la clase. Ok, Sofía, I can eat in class. Ok, I can eat in class. But remember, Sofía, that this is at the end. End of my school activities. Recuerden, esta es la última clase. Entonces, ya, al final de mis actividades escolares, what? Where you can use can or can't. Ok, tell me. Ahorita quedé la una y que terminaron. No, don't worry, Sofía. Recuerden que estamos en ese proceso de comprender toda la información. Como estamos en avanzado, trato de usar lo menos español, pero cuando vienen así, surgen esas oraciones, ok, checo, todavía no me están comprendiendo, entonces es a lo mejor que use el español. Recuerden que estamos en ese proceso de tratar de quitar inglés, quitar inglés. Quitar en español y que sea siempre lo mayor que podamos de inglés. Pero si veo que surge algo así, entonces ya vamos viendo, ¿no? Ok, remember, at the end of my school activities, o 1 o'clock, I finish school. Ok, so, tell me, using can or can. Sorry. Okay, thank you, Orlando. I can play something. Okay, I can play something. Very good. Okay, so you. Okay, sorry.
¿Qué hago después de las clases?
Ajá, terminamos ahorita la una. ¿Qué es lo que podrás hacer o no podrás hacer, Carlos? That's
bueno,
correct.
Okay. Entonces, okay. Digo.
Okay. Orlando, I can go out to the school. Okay, perfect. Excellent, Orlando. I can play something. I can go out to the school. Okay, very good. Interesting. Okay. So, it's 1 o'clock. We finish, you are free. Suppose you are free from school duties. So, okay, I can write the homework.
No importa que no tenga buena pronunciación.
No, recuerden que la pronunciación, que no los detenga, chicos, la pronunciación no los debe de detener. La cosa es que ustedes se animen, se sientan seguros y participen. I can study, okay.
I can do watch my TV.
Okay. I can watch my TV, okay. Okay, very good. Thank you.
I can eat my food.
Okay, very good. I can eat my food. Perfect. Excellent. I can sleep. Perfect. I will not do that. I can sleep.
I can play the guitar.
Okay, very good. Okay, very good.
I can study, for example.
Okay, very good. I can study. I can listen to music. Very good. Excellent. Good ideas. Okay, very good. Perfect. I can do the homework. I can't, Ruben says. Okay. Very good, okay, excellent, nice, that's what I'm looking, eso es lo que estoy buscando, ok, se animen y vamos con cosas sencillitas, pero después tratar de ir no complicando, a lo mejor hacer oraciones más largas, con más información, con más detalles. So, very good, excellent, very good, so we start making communicative class, aunque sea mediante el chat. Agradezco a los que participan. Recuerden las pronunciación, que no los detengan. Ustedes están comunicando. Ya le toca a la otra persona guardarse su opinión de que si pronuncia bien, no pronuncia bien. Ustedes están comunicando y eso es respetable. Se están comunicando y la pronunciación, les digo, se corrige. Con toda esta práctica, se corrige. Ok, very good. How to say ruido? Noise. Noise es ruido. Noise. Si quieres decir que a lo mejor algo está ruidoso o algo causa ruido, entonces ya hablamos de noisy, ruidoso. Pero como sustantivo, ruido, noise. Y ya noisy sería adjetivo, ruidoso. Ok.
I can't say mal, say for.
Okay, very good. That's a good one, Carlos. Very good. I can't go anymore after class. Oh, Sofía. Okay.
Estaría bien. I can't noise in the class.
I can't noise. Okay. Quieres decir hacer ruido. I can't make noise. Agregaríamos el verbo. I can't make noise, hacer ruido, make noise.
And thanks. That's
perfect, Adam. Okay, very good. Excellent, nice sentences. So, we can continue. Okay, as you read on the plan of activities, I'm going to share with you. I know that you read, but probably if you can't, so, let's see. Revision and workbook. Revision. Esa será una serie de ejercicios en donde ustedes irán nuevamente. Más que nada, evaluándose. Así que les voy a dar así tiempo para que vayan contestando. Y verifiquemos, sobre todo ustedes, qué tan oportuno pudieron recordar o tuvieron que ir al libro o estar buscando esa información. I can hear why is but because my noisy neighbor. Okay, I can hear O I can listen. Listen, no puedo escuchar. A ver, dejo de compartir para que lo chequemos. I can't listen, no puedo escuchar. Because of my noisy neighborhood o neighbor, ¿sí? No puedo escuchar a causa de mi vecino ruidoso, ¿ok? Ahí sería listen para que hagamos esa corrección. I can't listen porque estaríamos escuchando. O también puede ser hear, escuchar. I can hear. Because, porque recuerden, why es preguntando, ¿por qué? Y because, recuerden que es una razón, because my noisy neighbor. Ok, así hablo de ir haciendo cada vez oraciones más elaboradas. Very good, Alexia, thank you. Entonces, estaba con ustedes que vamos a hacer un tipo como examen, en donde ustedes solitos van a ir viendo, no voy a pedir que me digan su calificación ni nada. Sobre todo es que ustedes mismos se conocen. Vean qué tanto pueden contestar sin verificar apuntes o regresar a las páginas del libro. Y qué tanto recuerdan de todo lo que hemos trabajado. And then we have workbook. De ahí vamos a pasarnos a la sección de workbook, donde igual iremos resolviendo una serie de ejercicios. So, if you can open your book, please. So, let's open on page 20. So, we have the revision. Si se fijan, es 7 actividades y cada una tiene un puntaje. Entonces, algunas valen un punto, algunas llegan a valer 2 puntos y nos tiene que dar un total de 100 puntos para que podamos obtener el 10. Entonces, vamos a ir entre todo lo que hemos visto, checar vocabulario, checar gramática. También tendremos por ahí verdadero o falso, una lectura y terminaremos, como ustedes saben, redactando. So, page 20, please. So, let's start. So I say, number one, let's take 4, 5 or 6 minutes, dependiendo la complejidad. Cualquier duda, ya saben, me escriben o me preguntan. Damos tiempo, revisamos. Ustedes van palomeando, van corrigiendo. Recuerden, tache. No, por favor, tache, no. Y listo. So, activity one. Nationalities, please. Can you remember the nationalities? Traten de no, de ver cuánto pueden contestar, cuánto recuerdan de esos primeros vocabularios que vimos. Y ya, las que no recuerden, pues ya regresamos páginas atrás, please. So, let's take 4 minutes, probably 3, 4 minutes. And then we start checking. So, 11:48, 11:52, we start checking, please.
Orlando, ¿tienes tu micrófono?
Sí, cuidado con los micrófonos. Ok, Cristian, claro que sí. Con gusto aquí te esperamos. Tú no te preocupes.
Gracias, Miss.
Okay, what do you have? Which are the easiest nationalities that you remember? You can use the chat or your microphone.
Can you repeat, please?
Okay, thank you. So we have English, perfect. Spanish, perfect. Russian, perfect. Polish, I be careful with the Polish. Okay, Mexican, okay. Brazilian, perfect. Irish, okay, you remember Ireland, Irish. American, okay. Italian, very good. And what about Argentina? Yes, that's correct. Argentinian. Okay, very good. So you check if you got the 20 marks, obtuvieron los 20 puntos, o si por ahí alguno les falló, por favor no vayan a poner tache, solo corrigen y listo. Perfecto. So, no problems with nationality, so we can go to the number two. The odd word out. Recuerden, esto hasta lo hicimos para el test, para ver la nivelación. Esa palabra que no va con la categoría. ¿Cuál sale de esa categoría o de esa serie de palabras que van relacionados a un tema? So please, so read carefully and which is the odd word out. So I think that is easy. So 2 minutes probably. So is 11:53, 11:55. We start checking, please. Okay, do you have the answers? That you want to share? Okay, pilot is the first one, Diana, so let's see. That's correct. Okay. So pilot doesn't have to be with photography, cycling, horseback riding, so pilot now, very good. Right there for the next one. That's correct. Nothing to do with neck, nose, and chin. Perfect. Okay. Good work. Oh, wait there. So let's see. Good working, the good working, because we have professions. Electrician, waiter, nurse. So good working, no. Then Tuesday, very good, that's correct. So we have months, so a day, not. Okay. So chubby, let's see, it's chubby. Okay, very good. Then you say that the next one, lip. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Geography. That's correct. Nothing with parts of the face. July. Okay. A month with days of the week. Excellent. Thank you. Music. Okay. Very good. And sports. Excellent. Very good. Excellent. Perfect. Okay. So this is an easy exercise, so always be aware. Siempre atentos. No sea que en alguno cometamos un error por confiarnos demasiado en que está sencillo. Siempre una doble revisadita para que estemos seguros. Okay, very good, excellent. Very good, everybody. Excellent, thank you. So, let's go for number three. So, let's go there. Circle the correct word. Okay, read the sentence. We have affirmative, negative, interrogative. And which is the best structure? Verb to be, do or does, or have, negative with can. Okay, so read carefully. So let's count 4 minutes. 11:56, 57. So 12 with one, 12, one. We start checking, please. Okay, come on. Can you share the correct structure that you select for each sentence? What do you think? Okay, thank you. Let's see. Perfect. Isn't. That's the correct one. Excellent. Thank you, everybody. The next one, does. That's correct. Third person, Maria. Very good. Thank you, everybody. Wow. Thank you. Excellent participation. Excellent. Number three, aren't. Perfect. You remember two people. So it's plural. Very good. Thank you. The next one, am. Okay, so let's see. Perfect, very good. Recordamos, perfecto, que si hablamos de that, no tiene que ver nada have, sino es el verbo to be. The next one, do. Okay, very good, excellent. Thank you. Do you have? Perfect. Number six, can't. Okay, excellent. Can, that's correct. Very good. Excellent. Thank you. The next one, are. Okay, very good. Are you good at math? Perfect. Number eight, what do you think? Can, the same? Okay. Okay, very good. Thank you. Can you ride a bike? Okay, the next one, doesn't have? Perfect, doesn't have. Excellent. And we finish with, okay, perfect, can dive, but he can swim. Okay, very good. Excellent. No problem with the structure. I know that you are so good students. Okay, excellent. So let's go to the next one. Four, circle the correct item. So once again, read the sentence and choose which structure is the best. Okay, so let's take 3 minutes because this activity is a short one. So 12:02, 12:05, we start checking, please. Okay, so answers. What is your choice? What do you select? Okay, so let's see. That's correct. They are from Mexico. Very good. That's perfect. It's a subject pronoun. How? Okay, that's easy. Very good. Very good. Okay. Here. Perfect. Her favorite is soccer. player. Okay, very good. The next one. Okay, his parents are teachers. Very good. And finally, perfect. Who's he? Excellent. Who's he? He's Peter. Okay, perfect. Very good. Excellent. So we don't have problem with the double H words and with the possessive adjectives and the subject pronouns. No problem. Okay, so we can go to the next one. Five. Complete the exchanges. Conversaciones. Okay, so that's why we have A and B. So we have 12:06. So 3 minutes. 12:09. We start checking. Which is the best for each exchange? Okay, so thank you, Carol. So what do you think? Number one, which is the correct? Okay, so let's see. Very good. How about you? How are you, Leon? I'm fine, thanks. Okay. What about two? Bye, Ray. Have a nice evening. Okay. You too, Jake. Okay. Very good. Number three. Bye, Jamie. Bye, Mary. Okay. See you later. Okay, very good. Excellent. And so we finish with how it's going. Hi, Anne. How it's going? Not bad. And you? Okay, very good. So, no problem with all the activities. That's so nice for me. Okay, we can go to the next. True or false, please. Read the text and mark the sentences true or false. So, let's count probably 4 minutes. So, we have 12:10. So 12:14, we start checking. Please read carefully. Okay, thank you, Carol. So let's wait 2 more minutes. Okay, Diana, okay. Okay, perfect. So we can start checking. That's excellent. It's all good for me. So what do you think? Number one, Katie is English. True. It's false. Okay. Hi, I'm Katie, and I'm from New York, USA. So it was no English. American. Okay. So what about two? Her hair isn't dark. Is true or false? So I have false. So let's see. It's true. I have long fair hair. So, her hair isn't dark. Cuidado con esas oraciones en donde está en negativo. Entonces, tenemos que ver qué es correcto. So, be careful on that. Porque les digo, son cosas que nos ponen ahí para equivocarnos. What about three? What do you think? Her favorite school subject is art. So we have true, 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 true. So let's see. That's perfect. That's correct. Art. What about four? Kathy and Laura are good at history. False. Okay. So let's see. False. Okay. That's correct. So we have there. What about five? Laura's hobby is cycling. You say that is true? Okay. That's correct. Okay, perfect. You finished so early. Terminaron hasta antes. That's perfect. Very good. So we can go to activity 7. Write a short paragraph about yourself. Okay, we're going to use the notebook, please. And you have to include. You have to use the name, the age, nationality, what you look like, favorite subjects, favorite sport. So similar to the information that we saw before about Katie. So similar, but about you, your own information. So here we're going to have 5 minutes. Aquí sí, 5 minutos para que se concentren. You organize your ideas. Follow the model. Sigan el modelo from activity 6. So it's 12:14. No, 12:15. So 12:20. We start checking, please. Okay. Any question? I'm here. Okay, thank you, Carol. Okay. So, how can we check? Okay, aparte de que yo lo revise this last weekend or this weekend. So, similar to this. Okay, so let's listen the example.
My name is Pedro Vasquez. I'm Mexican. I'm tall and I have short brown hair and brown eyes. My favorite school subject is geography. I'm very good at soccer. It's my favorite sport.
Okay, more or less, you must have something similar to this. The name, nationality, description, what you look like, cómo se ven, cómo lucen. So always we say that the height, hablamos de estatura. We can describe so easy the hair and the eyes. Or you can talk about the size, if you are fat, slim, chubby, etc. And then my favorite school subject, or my favorite sport, or my favorite singer, or my favorite soccer player. Aquí puede ser cualquiera. And I'm very good at also. Entonces, más o menos, este sería como el modelo. Puede ser que ustedes tengan más que esta. Entonces, if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 34, 34 palabras. Entonces, más o menos que ustedes vayan con esa idea. Si tienen más, perfecto. Si es que pudieron, entonces más hablar sobre ustedes. Pero vean que llegan a 34, 40 palabras. Vamos bien. Pero esta es más o menos la idea que ustedes deben de tener. Tiene que ustedes tengan esta información, que es la principal. Nombre, edad, nacionalidad, cómo lucen. Y aquí nos hablaban de materia favorita, pero pues a lo mejor ahí puede cambiar. Deporte favorito, pues lo también puede cambiar. Ya depende, ¿no? De qué les guste más. Creo que es más que hablen de lo que les gusta que hablar de la escuela. Entonces, a lo mejor de ahí pueden hablar o redactar más. Pero esta es más o menos la idea, para que ustedes se basen, o si algo creen que le faltó, o si ustedes quieren estructurar, bueno, todavía tienen oportunidad al ratito que manden sus evidencias. Ok, and with this, we are closing the revision. Ok, so now we are going to move our book. So please, so from page 20, we are going to go to the page 50, ¿ok? En la página 49 van a encontrar el logo que dice Discover Workbook. Yo no cuento con el libro, pero si ustedes van a la página 49, va a estar en blanco, donde se ve con anaranjado Discover y abajo dice Workbook. Le damos vuelta y va a aparecer la página 50, 51, en donde aquí tenemos repaso. Les digo, todo lo que aquí viene es repaso para confirmar conocimiento, si recuerdan todo el vocabulario que se debe de, si recuerdan correctamente la estructura, todo esto nos va a servir. Entonces, estamos divididos en secciones: vocabulario, grammar, everyday English, reading, listening, etc. Vamos a iniciar con estas dos páginas, a ver cuánto podemos ir avanzando. So, we have vocabulary, 3 exercises. So, I'm going to give you 10 minutes, 10 minutos, para realizar los 3 ejercicios con toda tranquilidad. Recuerden, la idea es que tengan menos errores, que traten de que todos sus ejercicios, mínimo uno sea el incorrecto, pero la gran mayoría correcto. So we have exercise one, we have to match words with the pictures. Exercise 2, we have to read and choose the correct one. Exercise 3, complete parts of the face. Okay, so let's count 10 minutes. It's 12:24, 12:34. We start checking. Or if you finish before, let me know. Si es que terminan antes, me avisan and we start solving. Okay, so read carefully, please. And also you can check the notes. Okay, can we start checking these three exercises related to vocabulary? What do you think?
Mises, tengo una duda.
Okay.
¿Qué página del libro es?
Es la página...
Es que no lo encontramos.
Okay, en la página 50, o sea, vamos a ir a las últimas, viene la sección de workbook. Entonces, ahí es donde vamos a trabajar, es la página 50. Van a ver que en la 49 viene en blanco y dice Discover y viene con letras anaranjadas, Workbook. Y ya, no, sí. Si ya le damos, ok, perfecto, bien, 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 sí. Es que no tengo el libro, sino lo que hice con quinto, que sí tengo el libro, les fui mostrando, pero de primero y tercero no. No cuento con el libro del estudiante y entonces pues, se me complica más. Entonces, ahí van a encontrar. Vamos a ir durante todas estas habilidades que tenemos que dominar, el vocabulario, la lectura, la comprensión, el audio, el listening, el useful language, y vienen una serie de ejercicios. Entonces, de vocabulario, we have three that we have to solve. So we have the first one, match the words to the picture. So what do you see? Okay, one is C. So let's see.
Waiter.
That's correct. Thank you, Sofia. Two E.
Vet.
Okay, very good. Thank you. 3D, so let's see, let me find what is D, it's here.
Actress.
Okay, 4 is A.
Nurse.
Okay, 5 is B.
Architect.
And finally, we have F, number 6.
Firefighter.
Okay, so no problems. We also check pronunciation. So jobs are easy to remember. Now, here we start with a little of problems if we can understand the picture or the photo. Okay, so thank you. You say that is scene. Okay, very good. Scene. Thank you, Diana. Yes, Mia, Hector, thank you. Number one, she's thin. Okay. And young. Okay, let's see. That's correct. And young. Okay. Long. That's correct. With long. Okay, thank you, Sofia, Diana. Curly. That's correct, curly, with long, curly hair, and full, okay, that's correct, full lips, okay, full lips. So, we complete about she. Now let's go with photo B or picture B. Young. Okay, he's young, slim, okay, and slim, very good, thank you, short, okay, short, okay, very good. Straight. Oh, correct. Very good. With short, straight, fair hair, and blue eyes. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Excellent. So, let's go with picture C. What do you think? Old? Okay. Okay, it hits his late 40s, but I think that the best is old. Okay, vamos a tomar que es old o his late 40s. Cualquiera de las dos que hayan colocado en letter C is correct. Both are correct. Porque a lo mejor no es tan grande, pero como ustedes saben, Estados Unidos son el cabello muy rubio, parece casi blanco. So probably that we say that is old. So if you select old or in his late 40s, you are correct. Both are correct. Okay, so, and what do you think? Well built, well built. Okay, well built. Okay. Gray, okay. Gray. Strike. Okay. Strike, very good. Mustache. Okay, very good. With brown stripe wavy hair and a mustache. Okay, very good. Okay, perfect. Excellent. So let's go for the third exercise. Parts of the face. Do you remember all of them? What do you think? Number one.
Eye.
Number two.
Lips.
Perfect. Number three. Okay, so let's see.
Hair.
Okay. Four. Okay, so let's see.
Cheek.
Okay, cheek. Perfect. Number five. Let's see.
Ear.
Excellent. Very good. What about six? Okay, so let's see.
Teeth.
Okay, very good. Okay, you have seven. Perfect.
Nose.
Nose. Okay. Then we go with number eight.
Neck.
Okay, perfect. Then we go number nine.
Mouth.
Okay. And we finish.
Chin.
The chin. Okay. No problem with the vocabulary. Excellent. Very good, students. Boys and ladies. Excellent. So now we can go to the grammar. Okay. Exercise 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 and 9. Okay, aquí sí nos ponen más ejercicios. So, once again. 1241. So, 1251. Casi para terminar. Vamos a ver hasta cuál pueden llegar. Y you can complete 2, 3, 4 or the 6th. Y comenzamos a revisar, ¿ok? So, 10, 12, 52, we start checking, please. Ok, so let's go for the grammar. Activity 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Ok, we have to write a lot. So, read carefully, please. Read carefully. Okay, what do you think? Can we start checking exercise 4 related to grammar? What do you think? Is easy? It's difficult? Am, is, or are? Okay. So let's remember the verb to be. Okay, can you please give me your answers and we'll start checking? Esas páginas deben de estar de puras repletos de palomitas y palomitas y palomitas. Thank you, Carol. Okay, so we start so good. I am perfect, Kylie. And this, okay, thank you. Is my sister Serena. We, very good, thank you. So, what about three? What do you think about three, number three? We are? That's good. We are from America. Okay. We are. Very good. I? Okay. Thank you. Thank you. I? I'm 17 years old. I'm 17 years old. My favorite hobby? Thank you, Diana. Thank you, Carol. Is reading, and I, okay, Diana, Carl Miguel, okay, and I am very good, I am very good at painting basketball, okay, basketball is my favorite sport. Okay, and I, very good. I'm on the school basketball team. Okay, number nine. What about number nine? It is my dream to play for my favorite basketball team, the Boston Celtics. Okay, number 10, Serena. Okay, we continue with this. Okay, perfect. Is 15 and her favorite hobby? Okay, we continue with this. Is playing music. Okay, very good. 12, she, okay, is. Okay, yes, we have a lot of is. Is very good and... Okay, is, we continue, is her dream to become a famous singer like Shakira or Beyoncé? Serena and I, okay, are. Cuidado que porque veo el I y quiero colocar am, vean que dice Serena and I, Serena y yo. Ahí tengan mucho cuidado porque es trampa. Y si nos podemos equivocar, Serena and I, seríamos ya plural, nos toca el are. Serena y yo somos muy buenas en deportes. Ok. So, I think the verb to be, no problem. Ya ustedes identifican, nada más ser muy observadores, muy observadores. Eso también es inglés importante. Muy, muy, muy atentos a. Ok. Five. Now. Negative or interrogative with the verb to be. Ok. I think that we have time. Ok. Nos va a dar tiempo a revisar this exercise. So you say that this is. Ok. Let's see. Okay, is she a doctor? Yes, she is. Okay, we start with this. Very good. What about number two? Okay, I'm not. Perfect, Diana. I'm not an actress. I'm a lawyer. Okay, Carlos, thank you. Excellent. Okay, Hector, very good. What about three? What do you think about three? Okay, thank you. So let's see. That's correct. Are they from Mexico? And the answer? That's correct. Okay, that's correct. Thank you. Yes, they are. We use the same. Very good. What about four? Okay, Alexia, Carlos, let's see. Sofía, thank you, Fair. You are correct. They aren't 20, they are 22. Perfect, very good. Okay, let's go for number five. Okay, that's good. Okay, very good. So let's check. Perfect. He isn't a waiter. Okay. Number six, what do you think? Okay. Thank you. So let's see. Perfect. We aren't. Okay. Excellent. Excellent. What about number seven? I am from Portugal. Okay, so let's see. Which is the correct one? I'm not. I am from Portugal. I'm not Spanish. Okay. Number eight, nine, and ten, we need double answer. So what about number eight? Okay, very good. Is he a pilot? Okay. No, he isn't. Very good, excellent, thank you. What about number nine? What do you think? Is, are, okay, let's see, we have two possible answers. Are you a teacher? Are you a teacher? Okay, no. I'm not, okay, negative, no, I'm not, okay. And what about number 10? What do you think? Okay, okay, let's see. Perfect. Is he from Spain? Excellent, very good. And yes, obviously, once again, is. Perfecto, muy bien. Lo relacionado al verbo to be ya nos quedó bien claro. Muy bien, justo a tiempo. Terminamos un minutito ya lo que haríamos próxima semana. Es revisar los ejercicios que nos faltaron y seguir adelante, porque todavía tenemos bastante trabajo. Nos faltarían allí trabajos que hacer, pero vamos a dejar ahorita, ya van a descansar. Entonces, nada más recuerden, no olviden subir evidencias, las páginas que trabajamos. No olviden su pequeña redacción en donde hablan de ustedes, se describen ustedes, su introducción, y eso sería todo. Entonces, have a nice afternoon, take care of you, please, and see you the next week. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye, bye, take care of you, see you, bye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you. See you.